Hey, how's it going? Quinn Searcy, Searcy String Works. Welcome to my shop. Thought you guys might be interested in seeing a repair that I did this week. Eric, over at TalkBase, was noticing that the pickups on his Geddy Lee Signature Series Fender Jazz Bass didn't seem to be working properly. He'd always heard that in the middle position, with both pickups full up, you should lose the 60 cycle hum. It should have a humbucking capability. And he wasn't noticing this on his bass. When both of his were on full, he still had a good sounding bass, but he never got rid of the 60 cycle hum. So he went into the bass and reversed the leads on the pickup, thinking that perhaps one of them was wired backward. That's a pretty good hunch. He was smart in trying that out. But what he noticed was, now with both pickups on full, he was getting a humbucking capability, but the pickup sounded really thin and flat, almost as if they were out of phase. And after trying a few different things, we finally came to the conclusion that his pickups were out of phase, which meant that both of his pickups had north-facing poles. This isn't something you want in a jazz bass. The reason is, in order to produce a humbucking effect, you have to have reversed wound, reversed polarity, pair of coils. I'll show you what I mean. Here's my little cheesy test bass that I use for trying out different kinds of pickups, and it's got a set of my Neo Jazz Neodymium pickups in it right now. You don't have to have any specialty tools to check the magnetic polarity of your pickups. I have one. Years ago I bought this from StewMac. It's a little magnetic polarity tester, and it'll tell me real easy by flipping this magnet over. But you don't have to have anything like that. This is a 99 cent compass I bought at the Bass Pro Shop in a super mall here in Nashville. And it'll tell you everything that testing tool will tell you. You don't need anything fancy. If you take a look at this, I don't know if you can see that, the south needle of the compass is facing the pickup. Now, since opposites attract, that tells us that it has a north-facing pole on the pickup. On the other one, we see that the north pole of the compass is facing the magnet. That tells us that this is the south pole of the pickup. That's really all you need to check on that. I asked Eric to check this out on his bass, and both of his pickups had exactly the same magnetic polarity. Well, there's your problem. He wanted to know how to fix it. I asked him to send the pickup to me and let me reverse the polarity of the magnets. Here it is. It's a nice pickup. It's a four-bond type construction. This is the brown wire that Fender uses on most of their pickups. I think they use it on all of their pickups these days. It's got beveled magnets. That's actually something that they do just so that it goes together a little simpler, so that when they put it together it's cleaner. It just helps you shove the magnets through the four bond. I did notice that the soldering on this pickup is really bad. I mean, that's terrible looking soldering. That's not Fender soldering like any I've ever seen. Somebody's been monkeying around with this pickup at some point. I'll try and fix that up before I ship it back out. I want to try and put it in as original condition as I can. So I've already fixed this pickup. It's ready to go back out. But then I got to thinking that you guys might like to see how I went about fixing this pickup. It's not a terribly complicated thing. Basically, what you need is a jig like this. Because Alnico is so easy to demagnetize and remagnetize, any big, massive, powerful magnet like this has the potential to either demagnetize it, remagnetize it, or even change its polarity. As an example, I'll use this Strat bobbin. It's got Alnico slugs in it. Basically, what I do to change the polarity on these magnets is I force the north pole of these magnets against the north pole of my neodymium jig and the south pole against the south magnet. What this will do is swap the polarity. If you don't believe me, watch this. See? White needle facing the top of the pickup. This is the jig. It's a nice piece of walnut with a couple of nice massive neodymium magnets stuck through it. And it will do exactly what I need it to do. And after doing that for a little while, you'll notice that now the red north pole now faces the magnets. So we've reversed the polarity. So keep that in mind when you run across a problem with your instrument. You know, mistakes happen even on the assembly line. If you get your bass home from the store and you find out that it's not functioning properly, take it back. Make them check it. Because this stuff is usually under warranty and they'll have to fix it. Eric's bass, he's had it for years and years, and the warranty's probably no good anymore. So that's pretty much it. I'm going to go ahead and send this pickup back to Eric. And remember, if you have a problem with your pickups or any other kind of a tone type question on your instrument, drop me an email on the internet and I'll try to get back to you, and we'll see if we can't figure it out. Take it easy.